Hello again, folks. Welcome to another edition of Between the Banks. I'm Bob Goo, and I'm telling you, I got a gaggle of guests here. Luke's already hooked up. Stay tuned. We're at the island. You broke the ocean? Yeah, okay, now Luke, pulling this way. Stay tight on the 15-minute flight. Alright, stay tuned. We'll see what's on the end of the line. It's another Rock'em Sock'em edition of Between the Banks at the Islands. Stay tuned.
Between the Banks is brought to you by Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Louisiana.
This is our love, this is our life, this is our home, Louisiana. This is our day, come what may, this is our home.
Together strong, forever long.
This is our
up and down the bayou. That's how we tell you to get from one place to the other. It's a little different, but so are we in Louisiana's Cajun Bayou. And once you get here, you'll understand why our Cajun runs a little deeper. Find a piece of our story on swamp tours, fishing boats, at festivals, attractions, and restaurants. Visit lacajunbayou.com to plan your trip today. Louisiana's Cajun Bayou. Rich, natural, unapologetically Cajun. Just south of New Orleans, where Cajun runs deep.
Folks, everybody gets Between the Banks. Here's how easy it is. Go to your address bar, type in betweenthebanks.com, search, and here you are. The latest videos, services, and products provided by Between the Banks. Check it out, betweenthebanks.com. Everybody gets Between the Banks.
Alongside the boat. Let's see what this is. You gotta keep reeling. Keep reeling. You got it way on the other side of the boat. Keep reeling, Luke.
Alright.
Don't let him kick your butt.
Oh, yeah, you got some good pull to him, though.
He's coming, pumping and grinding him. He's doing perfect, folks. Now we'll see. Could be a bottom dweller. No telling. Taking drag. Could be a nice red.
Yeah.
It's just no telling. Okay, keep pumping and grinding, keep pulling this weight, not sitting on the boat. See what this is. Could be a ray. We just pulled up at Philo Bryce Island. We're in the North Cove. A lot of boats right around.
Oh,
nobody's doing
go.
Much. See what we got here. See what we got. Could be a big old...
Oh.
Haven't seen him yet. Oh, is that a speck? That's a speck, it's a mule. Bring him up, raise that rod tip up. Gaff? Oh, huge gaff top catfish. Alright, now, what's a gaff top, folks? A gaff top is a speckled trout shrimp. Where you see these, you're gonna see specks. Now look at the size of that fish. Most people never seen a catfish that big. But out here at the islands, big fish live. All right, so I'm gonna take this, flip this off, and I'm gonna introduce my guest. Stay tuned. Got a speck there, Luke.
I think I do too.
All right. Small one, but I think he's gonna make the cut. Now folks, last time, after the intro of the show, we were sitting at Philo Bryce. Well, the wind picked up. I'm sure you can hear it on the camera. And I bailed. Like I came in before things got out of hand.
Uh-oh, got a fish on.
That's a keeper. Oh, got a fish on up front. So, I came over to Bayou Blue to catch. Let's go see what Mitch has up in the front. So you just met Luke. Oh, another catfish. You just met Luke up in the front of the boat. I've got Mitch. And right here next to us, I got Danny. all from the Monroe area up North Louisiana. Now I'm gonna tell you folks, we're hammering the cats. We must have caught 20 cats so far. You know, catfish are on, but I'm homesteading right here in the S-curve of Bayou Blue, where you've seen us catch fish so far this spring. So that's what I'm doing. We got a keeper spec in the boat. That's embedded in a cat. Stay tuned. Give you how I'm rigged next. Stay tuned. Looks like you got a bull red on up front. Mitch is hooked up. All right, you're doing great, Mitch. You're trying to turn him. Just stay with him. Stay with him. You got you a nice little battle that's going to go on here. At least I think it's a bull. He's rodding up like a bull red fish, or maybe a smaller red. Then, of course, it could be the dreaded cat, but he's riding high. We're going to find out. Stay tuned. He's coming. I'm hoping he turns when he sees the boat. Keep him coming, Mitch. Pump and grind. Oh. You may not know he's hooked. A lot of these reds get up to 40 inches or so. Oh, yeah. Bull red taking drag. Oh, yeah, he saw the boat. He's out. Now, the question is he going to spool us on 12-pound test? Stay tuned, folks. We're going to find out. If I got to, I'll chase him. We're battling it. Looks like it might come close. I'm going to keep him turned that way. He's right here. He's right here. Let's see what comes up. If he comes up, we'll see exactly what he is. He's not ready yet. But you turned him, which is the key. When they start taking that drag, you gotta turn him and get him working. And all we're doing is just trying to wear him down so we can handle him. Comes up close to the side of the boat. It's all right. I'm trying to pull him down. Guarantee if this is a catfish, it's a wall. Oh, it's a nice red. Okay, take your time. Hold what you got. It's a nice red. Okay, too big for the net. I'm gonna bogey grip him. Stay with me, boy. Oh, come on. Ooh, it's a keeper red. We'll be able to keep this fish. Oh, yeah. Oh, yes. Yes. All right, it's not a huge bull red, but it's a nice red. One that's perfect for grilling. And there's a smiling angler with his fish. Now, how much does it weigh? Trusty Boga grip never lies. £19. And on the length, over 27. So, in your limit of redfish, you can have one over 27. And this one's just over 27. But look what's happening here, folks. Look at this tail. See the fluorescent blue that's coming onto his tail? That means they're getting ready to feed. So we've been patient battling the catfish, but you can see that blue coming. I'm gonna put this fish in the box. I'm gonna send my anglers home with some nice redfish. Stay tuned. Good job.
Bro. Good deal, thank you.
All right, folks, this is how I got the anglers rigged. I've got them on a team dial with 7-foot medium action rod and 12-pound test Berkeley Pro Spec low vis blue line. I'm coming to a black crane swivel number 10, and then I'm coming with my leader. This is triple fish camo line. I also use Berkeley Trilene Big Game, 30-pound test leader. And on this rod, I've got a 1/8 ounce weight. And what I've done is I've, instead of clipping a weight on, I've passed the leader through it once, then twice. That way, if I want to add a little weight to the hook, slow the minnow down, I can just slide the weight down and they'll stay pegged. Okay, so that's why I pass it, pass that weight there. Of course, I got it up on the top because we're Carolina rigged. This is a 1/0 kale hook through the lips of a Cockahoe minnow, a big goo-goo minnow. And you can see when I pass the hook through, I pass it through that tissue between the lips and the skull. I pass it through there, it closes his lips, and he can't tell the fish that Captain Bob's up here. Paying attention? Very good. All right, on the reel, a Revo. Revo 30 class, 3000H. Plenty enough line to catch bull reds and specks and reds. This is all available at Tides. You can go in there and ask for this rod and reel combo between the bank special, $150 with the line. Excellent deal. Of course, Tides has great food, nice grill, got a fish on, great tackle store. So that's how I'm rigged. Let's see, if this is another catfish, Captain Bob's out of here and I'm moving. So stay tuned here. Still got him or he came off? Took your bait?
Yes, sir.
All right, gonna rebait him up, move to another spot. Stick with us. We're still laboring through a tough day, but we're not giving up.
Keep a red.
All right, now that's the good eaters right there. That's the ones that really eat good. Folks, like I was saying, good thing I'm fishing with bass fishermen because it's brutal. These guys have casted. We're really struggling to get a show. We've had extreme wind from south filling up the ponds, high water. And these babies, we've seen them the whole time we're in here, but getting them to hit has been the issue. All right, now don't forget on redfish, gotta be 16 inches. You can have 5 per person and 1 over 27. That's your daily limit on redfish. And gotta be 16. And if he goes 16, he's gonna be a delicious eater because he's young reds, fillet them, really make for good eating. Let's check him out. Also, like I showed you on that other red, looking at his tail, we know the feed isn't on. We only have very little blue, fluorescent blue on his tail. That tail's got to get lit up and they'll really start grinding here. So, 16 inches. He's a keeper. All right, we're struggling, but we're telling you the truth. If it's a tough day, I'm going to show you a tough day. And believe it or not, this has been 2 tough days back to back, but we're not quitting diehards. Stay tuned. All right, Mitch is hooked up. Looks like he got another nice red. I'm running like one. You know, folks, I gotta tell you, today we've only caught one catfish. One catfish. Everything else. And of course, you come in the South Texaco field. I know y'all have seen many shows that I've done in here. Another really good, looks like it's a good eater. Oh, his tail is blue. Tail is lit. Good size, good size. Oh yeah, keeper. Bringing him right to the net. Now look at the spots on this redfish. So you can tell, but it's called reading a fish. Bass, you can read a bass. Tells you a lot just looking at him. Same thing with a redfish. Okay, so you saw that last red. You saw just the corner of his tail was done. Look at this one. Okay, starts at the bottom and he's working his way this way. He's almost got a full fluorescent blue tail. And then check out the spots, guys. Look at this. Look at the spots. You know, it's amazing. But looks like we've got another keeper red in the boat. Things are getting a lot better. Good job. Good job, bitch. Stay tuned. I think we got our first flounder. Still there, Luke?
Yes, sir.
Gotta bring him up. Just keep him out that trolling motor. Go to the front of the boat. There you go. Oh, he's coming up left side. Oh, no, you got... Is it a flounder? Sure is. Looks like a flounder. Keep him coming. Oh, no, it's a red. To the net. All right, another redfish. Another redfish. Boy, look, these 16, 17 inchers make for some really good eating. Now, you watching the show? Look at his tail. Almost blue all the way across. See that fluorescent blue? All right, we're gonna take this fish off. Good job, Luke. Got Luke Skywalker here, folks. Does that mean your dad is...
My father?
I am your father.
Yes, it does.
He didn't bring his... Oh, he does have his black hat on back there. Mitch, Luke's dad. Is that right?
That's correct.
That's correct. All right, so we're going to take this one off, folks. Let's go in and check out the marina minute. All the fine businessmen in Lafourche Parish that make your fishing trip down here complete. Starts with the Tourism Commission right there at Highway 90. Come on down the bayou. Got great freshwater fishing. A lot of La Rose, Lockport, Lake Fields. Come on down. Check your minute, make sure it's good. I'll give you a fresh one. Come on down. Galliano renovations. All the lakes there that you can fish. Catfish Lake, Sulphur Mine. Come on down to Leeville. Great food. Plenty of bait shops. Boudreaux's Waterfront Motel. Griffin's, where we get our ice. Really make a fishing trip to Leeville complete. Facilities like you wouldn't believe, and don't forget the boat launch. Fishing pier is going to be up pretty soon. You'll be able to bank fish at night. Handicapped elevated pier. Here's the marina minute, and I'm going to follow it with the map. Boudreaux's Waterfront Motel. Dock your boat at the end of the pier, right under your room. Set up your grill. Got your own fish cleaning station. Your own ramp. And for big groups, enjoy the sunset at the Boudreaux House. Boudreaux's in Leeville.
Griffin's Marina and Ice has bag, block, and blown ice for whatever size boat. Both dockside and roadside ethanol-free fuel, convenience store, breakfast, crispy chicken, all conveniently located in downtown Leeville.
Renovations is your complete marine center for sales, parts, and service. Pathfinder, War Eagle boats, Minn Kota motor guide trolling motors, power pole and Minn Kota anchoring systems, pumps, trailer parts. Renovations will keep you on the water. All right, folks. We're in the South Texaco field. We're working down the canal, hitting all the cuts. Wind was too risky to head back to Philo Bryce. So we're working the South Texaco field. You can see I've got 2 feet of water here where I'm anchored at. I'm casting into the ponds, 76.34 water temperature, so you know the fish should be on. And we got a current going by here about 1/10 of a knot. So we got a good tide range. Notice oysters. Look at the depth finder. See that blue line? Or on top of the red, and look how thick. Definitely showing a hard bottom. Here's a fish cruising by, even in that shallow water, passing by. All right, so let's go over to the pages, and we'll arrow over to map, enter. All right, So there's a good look at the South Texaco field. You can see I came down by Lafourche, just past the jackups, came into the South Texaco field, took my cross over to Dee's Canal. And you can see all my marks. Oh, we got another fish on. And I'm traveling down working the cuts. Let's check out this fish that we've got on here. I'm gonna grab the net. But still got him?
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Let's go get him. Let's get him on film. Reds are on, tails are lit.
He's going back around.
That's all right. Keep pulling him that way and he's gonna come back around. And you can see what I was showing you on the map. See all the cuts here? The pond, we're casting into it. Yeah, keep pulling to your left. To your left. There you go. He's gonna eventually come around. We can't get into the ponds. I'm in 1.8 feet of water and oysters. If I get shallower, I risk tearing the bottom of the boat up. So you gotta really watch your depth finders. I've got a depth finder on the front of the boat also. And by the way, great folks at Lowrance take care of all of my electronics. Got him out? Yep, sure do. Coming up left side with him. Keep away from the trolling motor now. All right, way to work him out of there. Now this is a flounder spot. Hopefully we're gonna pull a flounder. Oh, you got a nice red. Nice red. Ooh, nice fish. Stay tight on it and just hold tight on it. There you go. Keep, all right, now reel up some line. Keep away from the trolling motor. You got him, you're doing great. Doing great. All right, rod tip up. Pull that rod tip up. Don't bring it under the boat now. Rod tip up. Keep pulling that rod tip up. Oh, nice. Oh, yeah. Nice red here, Luke.
Thank you.
Luke,
thank
nice you. Fish. And look, he set the hook really good. It's in the corner of the mouth. Excellent job, right where you want to catch the fish.
You taught me well.
And if you notice, check out his redfish rig. I don't like to use a shotgun cork because it spooks fish a lot of times. So when I redfish, I just take my Carolina rig. Get this fish here. I just take my Carolina rig. I got a 1/0 kale hook. I'm coming up the leader. And no weight, no shock, just a shock leader, black crane swivel with a rattling clip on cork. And what Luke's doing is he's casting into the pond and just lightly popping, don't have to jerk because it doesn't take much to make those BBs rattle. And the minnow's swimming like crazy under the cork. If he gets near a fish and they're on, we know that blue tails, they're gonna clobber it. Now folks, I gotta be honest with you. It was rough. We started way back at Dee's Pond and we're almost halfway down Dee's Canal before the fish finally turned on. You gotta exercise patience and just jump from cut to cut to cut. Believe me, all these cuts are on now. Look at his tail. His blue's almost up to the dot. So life is good in this neighborhood. I'm gonna go take this fish, put it in the box, and then we're gonna get back and give you the coordinates for this canal. Nice red, bro. Nice red. In fact, he's Well, 24 inches. Good keeper red. Good keeper red. All right. Come back, I'll give you those coordinates. Good job, bro. Way to hammer. Okay, so back to the map feature. You can see all my marks here in this canal that I've marked in other shows that I've done. Look, this mark right here is 006. This mark over here is 0402. So this is really an old spot that I can always come to. And if you look good, Dee's Canal brings you all the way to Bay Hackberry, and this spot here is excellent for bull reds, okay? So, let's give you some coordinates. All right, this is north 29-13-978, West 90-13-334. Now you can tell this is where the boat is, and I haven't saved this spot, but I am going to mark it again. But you, like I say, mouth of the entrance, all the way into D's, all the way down there. So I want to save it, so I'm going to hit enter, and it's going to mark it. So there's the map feature, brought to you by the fine folks at Lowrance, with a redfish thrown in by Luke Skywalker. Stay tuned. Oh, speck. Nice big speck. Big speck. Bring him back. Oh, lost him right there at the boat. But y'all saw it, didn't you? Beautiful speck. Alright, that's okay. Make another cast. I'm telling you, this point here is just really lit up. Because of the fact that we got a big mud flat and a trench right around it with oysters adjacent to it, and it's just making for a great redfish spot. And now we're going to start catching specks off of it. That's all. Well, folks, there you have it, another edition of Between the Banks. But before I go, I've got to introduce you again to my podnas from up north. They've become my podnas. 2 days of fishing it took to get this show done, but they hung in there on high water conditions, and they hung in there, and they're gonna go home with some nice fish. Now, let me start with the young one, Luke Skywalker. My boy Luke, his dad Mitch, and then the guy with all the color and one of the toughest jobs in the world, Danny Hester. Danny, we're gonna tell him. Affordable bail bonds, right? Go ahead and tell him about your business.
I own a bail bond company out of North Louisiana, and if the devil made you do it, we'll get you through it.
And what's your famous saying?
We'll put your feet back on the street.
Folks, it's really been a pleasure fishing with these guys. So, you get in trouble in the Monroe area, you know to give Danny a call. It's been great fishing with him. Hopefully conditions are going to get back to normal. The bowl is going to drain, and we're going to get back to hammering the fish outside. But I know you can hear that wind blowing on the bike. Stay tuned. We'll bring you another edition of Between the Banks. In the meantime, good luck fishing. All right, guys, y'all be great. Y'all really did good. Good job. Pleasure. Good job, Luke. Danny, great job.